Before I even get started, subscribe down there. I got 50. Goodness, man, that is a lot. 50 subscribers. I think it's like 54 now. So it's actually people watching it. And you getting something from it? Tell a friend about it. Leave a comment down below. It's not like I got a million subscribers. I will respond. But today, real quick. Guys, I'm all about, okay, fashion and all that stuff. Especially when you can get deals on stuff or pay half of the price of on something that you would normally spend a lot of money on and pay full price for, okay? Now, like I've seen in one of my other videos, you go back, I talk about the different ways and different places you can get a lot of high-end designer stuff for half off or maybe even more than that. Depends on it. These shoes that we're talking about, which is the Dandy Love loafers from Christian Louboutin, okay, I got these for half off. It says Love right here, L-O-V, and this is like a pink E right here. I haven't worn them yet, but I'm going to wear them. There are like a velour, some velour action right in here. I know the way I walk on my feet, I beat my shoes up because I'm flat-footed and I walk hard. So these are going to be beat to crap. The first thing I do with all of my designer shoes, especially Christian Louboutin, like the dress shoes, I go and get a cobbler to sole them. So this is like a red sole, so I won't beat up the red part too much because that's what makes the shoe. Now the heel part is going to get beat up regardless, especially since it's got pointed edges right here. The first pair of shoes, I had them rubber this part, but they charged me so much for it, it's like it's not even worth it. Either way, though, honestly, if I didn't get the cobbler to do this part, this would still show. This red part would be right here, but I walk so hard, I'm flat-footed, I get mostly all of this part right here ends up being gone, like from here to here, okay? So it kind of takes away the purpose of the shoe. Like, these are hard, though, like, this is a shoe that a lot of people don't have. And if they do want to wear these, a lot of times they don't know how to wear them. They don't know what to do with them. Forgive me for forgetting the price. Let me see. Oh, okay. I got the receipt in here. All right. So the normal price for these is $1,000. Basically $995. I paid like $650 for them, which is a steal because I was going to buy these full price anyway. On any of these Christian Louboutin shoes, guys, especially when it comes to loafers and dress shoes, take advice from me. If you plan on wearing it, it's just like, you know how they always talk about how like the women's heels are not worth it, mainly because they're uncomfortable. And if you're going to wear a pair, you want to make sure you go somewhere and sit down. It's kind of the same way with the men's shoes because they look good. They're hyped up. But the quality of these is some shit. Like, I'll be honest with you. You basically wearing these for the hype. You wearing these to make people turn their heads. And you wearing these for the exclusivity of them. A lot of people are not going to have these. And if they do wear them a lot of times, they're not going to wear them right. I'm a big dude. Okay, I'm 6'6", 240. I dress extremely well, and I got a big foot. So somebody's going to see these. But if I'm a little 5'6" dude, 130 pounds, and I don't dress this up right, it's not going to have the same effect. Now, like to each his own. Like if you don't really care about people seeing it, cool. But with me, if I'm going to spend a lot of money on a pair of shoes, I want, especially on these, something like this. I even want them to be something that I really, really dig or something that stands out or a combination of both. So, guys, that is pretty much it. I got one more thing real quick. You go back and look at one of the videos. Guys, in late November, early December, in a lot of these high-end stores that you can walk into, they have sales. You just have to be on top of it as a sales associate. If you go in there during those times and you don't ask them what's on sale, a lot of times they're not gonna tell you. Like they have let's say this is a display with shoes, right? Okay. They have all these shoes lined up, right? And it'll look regular and normal. And then the sale sign will be as big as this charger. It'll be the sale sign will be over here. And they have a little block and it says sale on it. So, like, if you go in there blindly and you don't ask, you're too afraid to ask. See, a lot of people, man, when they go to these stores, they feel awkward going in there because they don't go in there. They think it's some type of protocol. They're worried about how the sales associate's going to judge me. Man, fuck that. They're there for you. So anytime I go in any one of these stores, like, yo, what y'all got on sale? Y'all got anything left over from the sale? Like, because a lot of times when you go in there, they make it seem like the people that work there, they make it seem like they buy that stuff or they spend their own hard-earned money on it. Man, they don't buy that shit. And a lot of times, let's say if I work at the Versace store and I know somebody that works at Tom Ford or something, right? I'm trying to use that person's discount or I'm gonna wait until they let me know about a sale at Tom Ford. A lot of these guys that work in that store, they make it seem when you go in there like they buy this stuff, but they get it for free. Or they wait until a certain time of the year where the employees get half off or 70% off of stuff that they're trying to get rid of, and then they'll wear it to work or something. But don't let them fool you. Don't make them make you feel bad about wanting to sell or wanting to get something cheap, because they do it their damn self. That's pretty much it, man. Comment, like, subscribe. If you got any questions, hit me up. And remember, you the flyest motherfucker on earth. I'll see y'all later.